Hi, I'm Dr. Raj, and I'm so happy to be here in Dr. Raj's classroom, and I think it's time for me to go beyond the pearls. So let me have a question. Look at the technology we have nowadays. So we have a 26-year-old female evaluated for muscle weakness. Stop right there. Anytime I think about muscle weakness, what electrolytes jump to mind? I think about phosphate, but don't forget our very common friend, potassium. Is it low? I don't know. Let's find out. And this muscle weakness is developing over the past several months. She has no focal symptoms and states that she's otherwise feels well. Medical history is unremarkable. There is no pertinent family history. And you know what? She's on no meds. That's always going to be important, especially if she does have low potassium. Why? What about those diuretics? They can lower serum potassium sometimes. And on exam, her blood pressure, it's bolded red. That means red flag. So it's 98 over 62 on the lower side. Heart rate's 98. I mean, not per se tachycardic just yet. Her respiratory rate is 16. Her BMI is rather low at 19. There is no lower extremity edema. And the remainder of the exam is unremarkable. They gave some labs, not just in the serum, but in the urine. So definitely we should take a look at those. So sodium is normal, but wait a minute. Potassium 3.1, that's going to be on the lower side. What did I say? When you have weakness, take a look at that serum potassium. Why is it going to be low? Chloride is 120, and the bicarb, you know what I did for everyone? Some bolded red. The bicarb is 15. That's below my magic number, which is what? 24. Patient's definitely going to be what? Acidotic. So looks like the serum creatinine is okay, but they gave us the urine electrolytes. Is that going to be a key part? Anytime we talk about this question, the answer is yes. But before I jump into that urine right away, let's go back to the serum. Anytime you have a metabolic acidosis, what will always be the next best thing to do to figure out the etiology of a metabolic acidosis? What did you say? That's correct. You always calculate the anion gap. So let's go to my trusty board back here. How do we calculate the anion gap? That's going to be the sodium minus the chloride minus the bicarb. So I put the values for you. This is going to be 142 minus 120 minus 15. Let's do a little mathematic. The answer is 7. So does this patient have a widening of the anion gap? The answer is no. And you're asking me, Dr. Raj, what is the normal anion gap? Well, somewhere between 10 to 15, but my magic number is 12. This number is 7. So this is a non-anion gap metabolic acidosis. So what is the next best step in evaluating a non-gap metabolic acidosis? It's going to be looking at those urine electrolytes. What are we going to calculate? The urine anion gap. So how do we do that? The formula is always going to be the urine sodium plus the urine potassium minus the urine chloride. And let's just put those values in there from the question. It's going to be 18 plus 8 minus 32. And once you do that math, the answer is going to be negative. Now, the key thing is I didn't actually put the value there because when we talk about the urine anion gap, I don't need the exact value. What I do need is to know if it's positive or negative. If it's going to be negative, maybe the etiology will be something from the GI tract, maybe some diarrhea. Or if it's going to be positive, it could be somewhere in the kidney. What's the classic thing that jumps to mind? Well, these renal tubular acidosis. You know what? I'm talking so much, I haven't even looked at the choices yet. So what is the question here, now that we evaluated everything, is that which of the following is the most likely cause of this patient's acid, base, and electrolyte abnormalities? Well, we know it's going to be a non-gap metabolic acidosis with a negative urine anion gap. So which ones make sense? Is this going to be someone with bulimia nervosa? Well, the answer is that if you're having the nervosa, the lots and lots of vomiting, what type of acid-base abnormality would you develop? What did you say? That's right. You would have a metabolic alkalosis. Is that what this patient has? The answer is no. Now, look at choice B. A Gittleman syndrome? What is a Gittleman syndrome? Well, number one, it's rare. Number two, it's a problem with the kidney, a problem with the tubule. Does anyone remember what tubule it's going to be? That's right. It's going to be somewhere in the distal convoluted tubule. It's like beyond excessive thiazide diuretics. These patients are losing lots of volume. These patients will develop a metabolic alkalosis. Why? Because they're so volume deplete. My favorite hormone is going to get secreted called aldosterone. And what does aldosterone do, everyone? It dumps hydrogen ion where? in the urine developing a metabolic alkalosis. So it can't be that. Now, is this going to be laxative abuse? Well, when you take lots of laxatives, you have lots of what? Diarrhea. Does that fit this? No, it does, but you know what? Let's be good. Let's look at all the choices first. Now, what about this choice D, taking lots of diuretics? Well, that's kind of like a Gittleman syndrome. That's kind of like a Barter syndrome where you take lots of loop diuretic. And what type of acid-base abnormality would you be if you deplete all the volume in the serum? Well, you get a metabolic alkalosis. Why? That hormone kicks in again, aldosterone, dumping that hydrogen ion in the urine. And last but not least, choice C is an RTA, that renal tubular acidosis. That makes sense. I mean, if you have an RTA, well, I guess you would have a non-anion gap metabolic acidosis. So the two ones that make sense to me are going to be C and E, laxative abuse or that RTA. But what was the deal breaker? The answer is that urine anion gap. In this case, it was negative. And the only one that makes sense here is going to be what? Choice C. Laxative abuse. So what is the take-home message for a non-gap metabolic acidosis? Look at the urine anion gap. If it's negative, always think about negative. The answer is the GI tract. Or if it's positive, think about the kidneys and RTA. I'm Dr. Raj, and I just went beyond the pearls.